Green Bay, Wisconsin, owning a home once seemed like an impossible dream to Jalisa Gray, though she dreamed about the possibility since the birth of her son a decade ago. Now that she finally has one, she sees possibility everywhere. She could paint her bedroom a calming light blue, the bathroom lavender, and the kitchen white and blue, like a country home kitchen. She can modernize the house while keeping its charms, like the old doors and crown molding. After years in rented apartments, she can watch her children create their own spaces. Up until 2 years ago, Gray was moving nearly every year. Twice, she lived in House of Hope, a Green Bay shelter for women and children. She steadily worked and improved her credit score, but she had another setback when the pandemic hit and she had to quit her job at a call center to care for her children. And even as she worked to recover from that setback, she faced another problem, because she receives food stamps and daycare assistance, and because those vital benefits go away once she earns a certain amount of money, she had to weigh the pay requirements for her benefits while seeking work during the pandemic. Gray isn't alone. For many people trying to care for their families, rent or buy housing affordably, and improve their household finances, a small increase in pay can mean a disproportionately greater decrease in benefits. This effect, called the benefit cliff, makes it difficult to make decisions about a new job or career advancement. In some cases, the additional earned income can cause financial stress. If I lose daycare assistance, I lose daycare, therefore I lose my job and I start back at nothing. And then I could lose my home, Gray said. People don't realize that cliff and losing one assistance, especially daycare, it's huge. And a 25-cent raise isn't going to pay for $1,700 in daycare a month. With a workforce shortage affecting some industries, employers are raising wages to attract workers. Low-income workers receiving benefits now have a better opportunity to reduce their dependence on benefits and increase wages, as long as they find wages high enough to survive the benefit cliff. Move here, get paid, small towns offer up to $20,000 just to get you to live there, work remotely, fewer jabs mean fewer jobs, states with lower vaccination, higher COVID-19 infection rates are behind in growth this summer while the minimum wage in Wisconsin has not increased, employers are offering higher wages as the economy picks up and workers are in short supply. This is due to a pandemic economy in flux, increased retirements, and more. The number of non-farm jobs has been growing in Wisconsin since February according to the Bureau of Labor Statistics, and the increase in available jobs is another factor behind recent wage increases. Businesses like retail, restaurants, and manufacturers are locked in competition for the same workers and raising wages.